Right now, but we're going to head back to Forbes, where Gabrielle Boyle is in Western New South Wales. Gabrielle, it's a nervous 24 hours there for the locals.
Absolutely. We left the hotel this morning. We were hoping to head down to the river and bring you some shots there. We needn't bother. The river has come to us here. It has crept right up overnight. I'm literally standing opposite the hotel where we're staying, and in the last few hours, that water has crept right up. It's a pretty eerie situation here, to be honest. It's a bit like a ghost town. They've got a lot of roads cordoned off. That water is still quite glassy, and it's quite calm, but it is moving at some rate now. So it's a nervous time. 560 people on evacuation orders. We've got three evacuation centres here set up. I know the medical centre in town has relocated to continue seeing its patients. So it's really a matter of wait and see. We know in the next 24 hours that water level is going to come right up.
Well, have they got any idea of exactly when it'll reach their peak? Obviously, that's tough to estimate. We've seen it go up and down in other parts of the country. But have they got a closer idea of when it will hit that peak today?
Look, it's really difficult to tell. They're telling us tomorrow at some stage we're going to see 10.5 metres. That's been downgraded a little bit. We were hearing yesterday 10.65 metres for Thursday, but it's really just a matter of wait and see. But look, let me tell you, that little bit of difference, I don't know whether it's going to make a huge amount of difference, because it really is a dire situation here. We've got so many properties and businesses already underwater, and it's looking to be, to get so much worse in the coming hours. Yesterday, I took a flight out in the SES chopper to take a look at the damage to the surrounding areas, to the farming areas, to the animals and the livestock. It really isn't a pretty situation. You've got so many properties isolated. You've got so many animals really stranded in the middle of nowhere. So it's a really awful situation for townsfolk here and people in the surrounding areas.